going to be demonstrating a centerline dressing change. First, I'm going to come into the room and I'm going to wash my hands or sanitize my hands. Next thing is I want to educate the patient on the reason for us doing this dressing change. The other thing is I want you to notice from my elbows down, I don't have any jewelry, watches, long sleeves. Make sure my name tag, if you've got a lanyard, that you're flipping it back behind. So we want it out of the way. So as I'm doing the sterile procedure, there's no risk of me breaking that sterile field and causing any sort of an infection. So the next thing that I want to do is I want to make sure that I am putting a mask on myself. And I also want to put a mask on the patient. There is a mask inside of the dressing change kit, but it's a little bit harder to access and it's just easier to have one already on you and already on the patient to start the procedure. For our recording purposes, I would make sure that I would keep this all the way through, but for our purposes, I'm gonna just pull it down so you guys can hear me. Next thing is I wanna make sure that I am putting a mask on the patient. And the reason for that is so that patient doesn't accidentally contaminate the field of their center line once we've taken that dressing off. And then I'm gonna take the patient's head and just have them turn their head away from it. Same thing, just to prevent any sort of infection to that line. I'm gonna go ahead and put my gloves on, and then I'm going to move to taking off this old dressing. As I'm doing that, I wanna look at the site, just making sure it looks good, it's not red. So I'm gonna take it off, and sometimes what you can do is to remove this tegaderm that's on there. Sometimes it can be pretty sticky. If you take it and you kind of pull out on the dressing, it helps remove it. The other thing I'm doing with my other hand is I'm kind of placing my hand right onto that line just to help stabilize it. So as I'm pulling that dressing off, I'm not pulling right onto the line. The lines should be sutured in on our mannequins. They're not. So you may want to just help stabilize that line as I remove it. And I'm just taking a look and making sure there's no redness, making sure that everything looks good with that. And I don't want to touch the site. So I've got that off. I've inspected my site, made sure that it looks good. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to remove my gloves. Now I'm going to open up my kit. So I've opened up my kit, and this is going to be a sterile procedure. When I open this, it's going to have a little tab, and we're gonna pull that, and that wants to be the one that we're pulling away from us. So I'm gonna take this, and I'm gonna open that, and there is my other mask. So if we wanted to use that on the patient, we sure could. So I am now opening up my sterile kit, and I need to make sure that I'm only touching on that 1-inch border around. So I'm opening up my side. And as you can see, I have to make sure that if this folds back in, that I'm not touching anywhere on the inside, okay? So I wanna take that and pull that. You see that? So we've got it open. I wanna make sure it's not folding back in on itself. And then the next thing that I wanna do is I wanna make sure that I am taking my gloves out, and I'm really careful that I'm not touching anything else in there. So I'm taking my gloves and I am going to put them right to the side of my sterile field, and I need to be really careful that I'm not touching anything in my sterile field until I've got my gloves on. So I'm gonna take my gloves and I'm gonna open them up. This has a little bit of the paper that kind of folds down. Sometimes you can take that and kind of push it up, and that might help this stay open a little bit better. Okay, when I am placing my gloves on, I've got to make sure that I'm doing it sterilely. If for any reason I contaminate my sterile field, you need to start again. Same with pass-offs. If for any reason in the middle of it you contaminate your sterile field, you need to say that and then start again. So I'm going to pick up my cuff right here, and I'm going to slide on my sterile glove. Okay, once I've done that, I can now stick my sterile glove on my right hand inside of my cuff. And I'm gonna show you that once I can get that in there. So I've got it inside of my cuff, and I'm going to put my other hand inside. Once I've got those on, if I need to adjust, I can adjust. Now that my hands are sterile, I need to make sure that I am maintaining that above my waist and that I am not dropping my gloves, my sterile gloves, below my waist or my sterile field. Okay, so the next thing that I want to do is I am going to kind of get this set up and ready for me to go. So I'm going to take my alcohol swabs, and I'm going to show you what's in here. So we've got our alcohol swabs, and there are three of them. We've got a piece of tape that we can use at the very end after we've placed our new Tegaderm, just to verify that we are not, just to kind of helps make sure that it's really secure. I've also got a 4x4, and I can use that to pick up the lumens to clean underneath it, so I maintain sterility. We've also got a Tegaderm, and I'm just gonna kind of take that and I'm gonna bend back that plastic piece just to make it easier for me to grab it when I'm done. We also have our ChloraPrep, okay? So first thing that I'm going to do is, I'm going to take my alcohol swabs and I'm going to clean the site. And I wanna make sure that I am scrubbing it and cleaning any sort of exudate, debris, anything that's on there. And I wanna make sure that I am just cleaning really well at the insertion site and also on the lumens. So I'm gonna take this and I'm just gonna scrub around and get that all clean. If I'm having a hard time getting up and around the lumens, then I can take my, and I'm gonna show you this. So I'm gonna scrub one more with this. You can use all three if you don't need to, you don't have to. But I'm making sure that I'm not turning my back onto my sterile field. But if I need to, I can use this to lift up my lumens, and I am going to swap hands. I'm gonna use this to pick up my lumens, and I can use this to get up underneath and scrub if I need to, if I'm not getting a really good. If you can get around your site, you don't need to worry about that, okay? Next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take my ChloraPrep, and I'm gonna activate that by squeezing the two wings, and I'm going to squeeze that. And then after I do that, I want to make sure that I am scrubbing either back and forth, up and down, and I want to scrub everywhere on here, okay? So I wanna make sure that I'm scrubbing the insertion site. I want to go 3 inches from the center out, all the way around. So I'm scrubbing up and down, side to side. I'm going down 3 inches down the lumens. I'm scrubbing and I wanna scrub for at least 30 seconds. So once I have scrubbed that, 28, 29, 30, I am going to allow that to air dry. I don't want to blow on it. I don't want to wave on it. I want to make sure that I'm maintaining that sterility of that side and that we're not introducing anything to it. Okay, the next thing that I'm going to do is I am going to take my Tegaderm and I'm going to allow that to completely dry. Once that is completely dry, I want to put my Tegaderm on here, and some of the Tegaderms may have the CHG impregnated gel here in the center. And if it does, you just want to make sure that your insertion site is right in the center of that gel. If it's not, that's okay. We're just going to make sure that we're placing our central line insertion site right in the middle of the Tegaderm. Okay, so I've let that dry. I'm now going to place that onto here. And I'm just going to take this strip that's off around the outside. And as I do that, I'm just going to continue to press down on that dressing. And make sure that we have a good seal. There is a little label right here that I want to make sure that I am labeling with the date, time, and my initials of when I completed that dressing change. And when we put that on there, we just want to make sure that we are not covering the insertion site. So I have filled that out and I am going to just stick it here on the edge. Okay. Next thing is there is this extra piece of tape and I'm going to use that just to stabilize where my lumens come out of the dressing. So I'm gonna take this, actually, yeah. I'm gonna take this and I'm going to rip it in half. So I'm gonna take one dressing, this tape, and I am going to stick it right underneath. And I want to cover my edges of my central line. So I put it right underneath the lumens and I came up onto that central line just to help secure that down a little bit. And then I'm going to take the other piece and go right over the top. That'll just help secure those lumens and secure that dressing so it'll adhere and not come off when it's, you know, if these lines are being used or whatnot. Okay, and then after I am all done, I'm going to make sure I cover the patient back up and just clean everything up from the procedure.